What's going on, guys? It's Black Poison, or Michael here from DaBlackgamers. We're going to be doing a landing challenge in Kerbal Space Program. Now, Kerbal Space Program is basically a space simulator. You have to get into space, orbit, visit other planets, visit other moons, etc. But we're going to be doing a landing challenge. So we're going to try and land a space plane from space with rocket engines. Now, there are a few things. I have infinite fuel enabled, and I also have atmosphere heating disabled, which means that I'm not gonna heat until I go into space. Probably stall. Yeah, not doing that again. Okay. So, that was just to see how it works. So, basically, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna have two tries. Once I get it to 2,000 meters, it's not, like, I can't just retry. I'll actually have two tries. It's going to use up one of them to start. So I'm going to be doing a challenge on my blitz. And you guys will tell me what to do. And you... just take off, okay? You guys will be telling me what I should do as a challenge. It has to be something I can record and something I can do easily, and I won't get banned from it. Let's just say that. Okay, so we're... gaining lots of atmosphere now, so we're going to phase down the engines. We're going to still accelerate, however, we're going to do so as quickly. Once I get to 2,000 meters, it's going to use up one of my two tries on this challenge, which means if I don't get this landed in two tries from space, then, or 70,000 meters, then I have to do the challenge, but hopefully I can actually win this. Come on. I still have, some air going around me, but it shouldn't affect much. Let's turn it up a bit. Turn it up to, this notch. Crashed as well. That is 1,200. And a 2,000. My brother just went to school. If so, it's going to be one more try as well. So this is a risk I'm going to take. And I'm under my pressure. Trying to grab this down to 2 hertz. And pull the nose up a bit. Okay, so I'm decelerating. Such as again, oh my gosh. Okay, well, so much. I'm 20 degrees facing up. Still accelerating from 5,000 meters per second. Infinite fuel and atmosphere heating is disabled, but I should have atmospheric stress, which means any small movement at fast speeds in the low atmosphere means I stall and I basically flip out of control. So if I crash into the ocean, yeah. Oh gosh, my nose. Still climbing. 14,000 meters. At 60,000 meters. soon as I should be clear to enable full power, because that's the point where it was like almost no atmosphere. So I'm going to put about 70,000 meters of space where there's actually no atmosphere. So what's going to happen is I'm going to try and orbit this. I'm going to make an orbit out of this craft, and then I'm going to deorbit it and attempt for a landing. Hopefully not on water. If it's on water, I'll have to enable full power. And until I get to land, which I can land it.
Pun.
Sorry, that's not going to happen again. So, 870. And that's the moon there, but due to orbital stuff, orbital physics and stuff, it's not going to be there if I ever accelerate it up to that point. So we're reaching 1,000 meters per second. I'll increase the power because there's not much atmosphere, actually. Oh, okay, I'm getting heat now, but the heat shouldn't kill me. It's just that means that's a lot of that's academic stress. I'm still in school mode. Academic stress. Atmospheric stress. My nose is really bothering me. Oh my gosh. Punch my nose because it itches. That's 1,200 meters per second. That's really fast. Okay, guys, we're back. Sorry for the short break. My throttle took a hit, which was strange. Let's see. We're reaching 50,000 now. So, Windows start loading that. To make an orbit. So, we're reaching 55,000. So that is 70,000, but we're going to wait till 80,000 to readjust. And that is 85,000. Let's go. Okay. So we're going to put ourselves down now. Make ourselves a nice little orbit. Oh, that's not going to be a very round orbit. But it's going to be an orbit. So that's 10,000, so we're going to come in for a landing there. I guess we don't even have to deorbit ourselves. So we're going to put the time warp up now. Now we're up to 3. And once it hits 70,000, we can go any even further. So that's 70,000. Time warp myself up to 10. The music is nice. So we're in space. Bet we're gonna land somewhere. Looks like we're gonna have a night landing. Actually, no, we're gonna have a day landing. Enjoy the beautiful Earth down below us. Actually, the takeoff was less than I thought it would be. Or less stressful than I thought it would be, the takeoff and the increase period, I guess you could say. So yeah, the plane is flipping up, but that is just due to orbital stuff, so I'll flip it back down when we resume time, but I can't now. So 250,000. I'm just kidding. So 253,000. And we're heading back down. The time warp will automatically pause once you reach 70,000, which means I can readjust myself. Or the time will reach times one, sorry. That is 950,000? 950. Seriously, this is the second time! That is 2,000 on the orbital velocity. See the sun again. We're passing the nighttime phase. We're entering the daytime phase. We're accelerating further and further downwards. The atmosphere should automatically slow us down, however, I am going to try and slow us down manually. And that is 80,000. And back to 70,000. Yep, see? I'm flipping ourselves back up. I'm going to enable the engines a little. Okay, let's see where we are now. 12,000 is. So we can slightly speed this up. There's the atmosphere heating, which would usually burn us up, but however, we have atmosphere off, because of this fact that it's going to burn us up, like, completely. I would turn us around now, but atmospheric stress... down pretty soon, hopefully. Yes, we're slowing down now, actually. Thank you. close. How about back to Burbraid? No, let's just...
suspenseful. I was like completely silent, focused on gaining the control of this craft. Oh my gosh. Power engines even more.
So basically, once once I get below 50 meters per second on the ground of, or like once below like maybe 30, 30 sounds good, 30 meters per second on the ground of this thing, it counts as me winning, so that like I don't like 15 meters I hit a rock and crash. That would not be great. X. Do not meant to clean up quickly. Dropping to 170. Just to think, we were at 2,000 earlier.
He gives the harmony orb and then just leaves it right away.
Brandon, shut up. Thank you.
Yeah.